The Ender Dragon. If you've played Minecraft before, chances are you've tried fighting it at least once. Considering that Minecraft is the best-selling video game of all time, you could argue that the dragon is one of the most iconic boss fights in video game history. It should come as no surprise, then, that on the oldest Anarchy server in Minecraft, the dragon has been through years of punishment, having been killed thousands of times by now. But 2B2T's dragon is not your typical Ender Dragon. Over the years, as the End landscape has slowly been corrupted, so has the dragon and its behavior. The boss fight has completely changed due to player infrastructure and the server's lag. It's much harder to kill, and at one point was even considered to be invincible, preventing players from leaving the End Dimension safely. On top of that, the dragon eventually glitched out to the point that when it was killed a few months ago, it generated a brand new dragon egg, which in the Java edition of Minecraft should be impossible. I'm sure you have a lot of questions, and trust me, the answers are just as bizarre as you would expect. Today we are discussing the history of 2B2T's Ender Dragon, and how this once simple boss encounter ended up as a Frankenstein monster kept alive in order to hold an entire dimension hostage. It's very fascinating how a fight that is supposed to be the same every time has evolved into something completely different thanks to players, their exploits, and the bizarre landscape they have created. There's a lot to cover today, so let's get started. In the past 10 years, the Ender Dragon has had two different versions on 2B2T. Its original 1.0 release form, and its updated 1.9 form. Its original form was only killed twice on the server, once in early 2012 when illegal end portal frames were used to access the End Island, and a second time in 2013 when the server's admin, Housemaster, reset the End Dimension and portals were made available to the public for the first time. From 2012 to 2016, these are the only two encounters that have ever happened with the Ender Dragon, and they were pretty much carbon copies of what you would experience in a single-player world. Destroy the End Crystals so that the dragon can't heal itself, then deal the final blow. For 3 years, the End Island remained relatively quiet, but in the spring of 2016, when the combat update came to 2B2T, the dragon was finally able to be respawned using manufactured End Crystals. This is where the fight began to slowly change over time. The dragon's new gameplay mechanics, such as explosive fireballs and lingering breath, made it a tougher battle. On top of that, 2B2T's main End Island had sustained some decent damage from years of players whittling away at it. It made moving around during the fight tedious. Since Totems of Undying did not exist yet, this was one of the most dangerous times to fight the Ender Dragon on 2B2T, as getting launched high into the air could spell disaster if you weren't prepared. Despite all of this, the dragon fight still worked as intended, and could be done even in vanilla. But as 2016 continued, a large influx of players came to 2B2T from YouTube and other websites, and the destruction of the main End Island began to rapidly increase. It was around this time that a discovery in the general Minecraft community was made that, when brought to 2B2T, would turn the relatively tame dragon fight into a nightmare. It involved invincible End Crystals. When regenerating a dragon, the crystals at the top of all towers reappear, but if you push them with a piston while the dragon's respawn animation is still playing, it makes the crystals invincible to all forms of damage. 2B2T player Bubba J was one of the first players to move crystals around and even brought one to the overworld near 00. It was a fun novelty at first, but by 2017, players began to realize that leaving these crystals right next to the towers they spawned at meant that the dragon could keep itself at full health. If there was at least one of these crystals active, killing the dragon became a monumental task, even with multiple people. If there were two or three of these crystals, it became impossible. No amount of damage done to the dragon could outperform the crystal's healing. Players would exploit this in order to keep the dimension's exit portal closed. This prevented anyone from leaving the end safely. If you wanted to leave, you'd have to throw your items into an e-chest and jump into the void. In a way, the entire dimension was being held hostage. The only way the dragon could be killed was by moving the invincible crystals away from the main island. In fact, if you walk on the end highways today, you can still see some of these crystals floating out in the open. They had to be pushed that entire distance by pistons. But because they are invincible, they could also hypothetically be pushed back as well. But from 2017 to 2019, the server went through cycles of the dragon being killed, a new one being respawned, which allowed for more invincible crystals being created, and those same crystals having to be pushed away from the main island. If you didn't push them, you had to deal with a practically invincible dragon. Using crystal aura while it was near the exit portal was the most reliable method of killing it. And as crystal aura hacks improved over the years, it made getting a quick kill a lot easier. But in late 2019, the dragon fight became even more convoluted when most of the lava casts at end spawn were bombed out and the entire end island was flooded with a water cube. Crystals cannot be placed underwater, and arrows don't pass through water easily, so fighting the dragon in this new artificial biome turned out to be a major headache. In addition, this new end ocean actually changed the dragon's behavior. In any given Minecraft world, the dragon is hard-coded to stay around 0-0, but for some reason, all of the water and obsidian structures on 2B2T caused the dragon to fly much higher in the sky than it normally would, and could often get stuck there. Since it flew so high, it became common to see the dragon diving down into the water when it became unstuck. Quite a bizarre sight. But that's not even the most bizarre part. I recently spoke with 2B2T player Mahan about his experiences killing the Ender Dragon in the water cube a few months ago. He mentioned that at some point last year, someone had actually obtained another egg from the dragon after it was killed, which in the Java edition of Minecraft should be impossible. Once the first egg is taken, it should not spawn again under any circumstances. While some suggested that 2B2T's end dimension was corrupted in a similar case to what happened in the overworld last year, I spoke with technical Minecraft player Iron Exception, who thinks that the egg respawning may have to do with the exit portal being tampered with in some way. It's all very strange. What started as an iconic boss battle has ended up with players making the dragon invincible, changing its behavior, and now the dragon's exit portal being tampered with in order to glitch out the egg. I almost feel bad for the old girl. You know what else makes me feel bad? The fact that some of you haven't hit that like and subscribe button, and if you're in the half that are subscribed, you're pretty awesome. Anyway, that's it for today's history lesson. Take it easy, FitFam, and watch out for swimming ender dragons.